Life Worth Living. From Lithuania to Boston, My Journey of Building Resilience. By Luba Sakharuk. Narrated by Emily Lawrence. Dedication. To my beautiful daughters, Elena and Anna. You are only teenagers now, but it is already clear you are both amazing people with compassion and kind hearts. You may have different personalities and even different interests, but the sisterly bond you have is forever. Cherish it. I am too grateful to only have a single dedication, so here is dedication number two. To my Aunt Manya, who had the courage to bring not only her sister to the US, but the whole mishpacha, aka family, Simiu. To my grandparents who survived World War II and raised my parents to be caring and selfless people. To my parents who gave us what they could and raised us the best way they knew how. You guys did a pretty good job, if I may say so myself. To my sister, who is brilliant in everything she does and has been there for me all my life. You mean the world to me. To my husband, who believed I could accomplish more than I could have ever imagined myself. You turned out to be an amazing dad as well. Bonus. To all who have touched my life, thank you for being you. Keep feeding and spreading kindness. Foreword. When life gives you lemons, you write a book. That is Luba's life in a nutshell in 2020. This book is a fascinating memoir, but it is also so much more. It is a jigsaw puzzle of bits and pieces that make up who we are. Flickers of memories, shards of pain, moments of reflection, bits of loving kindness. It is a guide to a stronger, more resilient self. It is a map to a better life. I am Luba's slightly older and, on a rare occasion, wiser sister. With the exception of our mother, I have known her the longest of any living person in the world. While she has many praiseworthy qualities, if I were to describe just one thing that makes her special, it would be her phenomenal ability to easily and organically build strong and lasting relationships. Her network of friends, extended family, colleagues, and acquaintances is vast, geographically distributed, and forever growing. One would expect that it would be impossible to have deep connections with so many people. After all, many of our relationships formed at the time of rapid change and social media are superficial and shallow and fade as quickly as they appear. Yet Luba, with her empathy and positive outlook on life, manages to create bonds that, though often characterized by occasional and infrequent interactions, withstand the test of time. Is it a blessing or a curse? One could argue that such a natural ability to connect to people, quickly and on a deeper level, is a practical, soft skill that comes in handy in a wide range of personal and professional situations. However, being a good friend and confidant to a person, being in their inner circle and privy to their personal challenges, also often exposes her to their pain and loss. For someone who is not a medical, mental health, or social work professional, Luba has witnessed quite a few tragedies in her social network and helped numerous friends and acquaintances deal with difficult situations without the benefit of professional detachment. While Luba does not divulge the details of such interactions, she will share on occasion that yet another friend is dealing with a loss or going through a difficult time. Over the years, I pondered on many occasions whether it was worth it and whether her ability to relate and empathize was causing her too much pain. But I have also witnessed her growing stronger and more resilient, taking pain and anger, whether her own or witnessed through her interactions with others, reflecting on, learning from, and
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.